We are looking at the concentrations of PFAS at the southern corridor of Lake Michigan.
Ready?
Yes.
I work with Lake Michigan Coastal Program in collaboration with the Indiana Department of Natural Resources and also NOAA. We call PFAS this group of chemicals that are fully fluorinated, and they are very useful for industry and several applications. We have them in waterproof jackets, or we also have them cover non-stick frying pans. They are very, very useful, but once they are released in the environment, they're gonna be there for several years or even for decades. We are concerned about them because they can also cause several health issues, as for example, immunosuppression, several types of cancers, and they decrease the response for vaccines. So we go to the field, we collected around 100 ml of water.
We just take three samples for beginning.
Coming back to the lab, we're gonna analyze the water and sediment with different techniques. Water sample is like a photograph of that moment. So we wanna see what is being inserted in that system. And with the sediment, we know that the sediment can act as a sink for organic compounds, as for example, PFAS. What we are finding in the Southern Lake Michigan corridor is 10 times higher than what EPA regulates for PFAS in drinking water. When you talk about the environment, we have to also think about environmental justice. Who's been more affected?
So like 1 meter in?
Yeah, 1 meter. And if you go there and you look at those locations, you can see that the population's mainly composed of Afro-Americans, immigrants, and people that are considered as minority. This population that lives there, they are being highly exposed.
So I think it's a 3 liter bag.
We want to generate data so the decision makers can see it and can act. But we also want to talk to the society and translate our finds.
I'll give you this one.
Yeah. We need attention for this problem. We need action, and we also need education, because informed people can really make a huge difference.